again, and welcome back to the 6-5 Summit. I'm Shelley Kramer, one of the founding partners of Futurum Research, and on behalf of our team here at Futurum and the team at More Insights and Strategies, we're really glad to have you. In this keynote session, we'll hear from Amy Fowler from Pure Storage, and she's going to talk with us about the secret to solving modern analytics data challenges. Pure Storage is one of the fastest growing IT companies in the world. Their mission is to help customers put data to use and also reduce the complexity and the expense of managing the infrastructure behind it. That means delivering a modern data experience that lets operations run on an automated storage as a service model seamlessly and across multiple clouds. That solves a lot of problems, doesn't it? If you're looking for ways to put your data to better use, as well as giving your technologists some time back, which I think they might want, this is one keynote you won't want to miss. Let's get to it.
Thank you so much for that introduction. I'm very excited to be here today. So today's challenges and opportunities for most, if not all, organizations revolve around data. How do we capture it? How do we store it? How do we analyze it and turn that analysis into actionable value? The sheer volume of data makes that final step, modern analytics, both a daunting task and a tantalizing path to competitive advantage. So is there a secret to execution? Because all of this sounds fairly difficult. And while I don't think there's a one-size-fits-all solution for every organization, there is one common foundation that successful modern organizations all seem to have: a strategic outlook on infrastructure. Infrastructure isn't the snazziest tech by any means, but it becomes increasingly important every day. Our recent societal shift to virtual environments, driven at first by factors like increased remote workforce and now required to curb the stop of COVID-19, has led to yet another burst in data and a need for even more sophisticated analytic tools. All indicators show today's Zoom-driven world is here to stay. We live in a world driven by data analytics and AI more than ever, and the new instances of this dynamic arise in our lives daily. Let's take two of the most personal things in our lives: healthcare and finance. For example, when it comes to healthcare, visits to the doctor have gone virtual, and soon more physicians will measure our vital signs through connected devices without the need for a physical visit. At the same time, drugs are being customized to our individual genetic makeup, and x-rays and MRIs are starting to be diagnosed by AI with fewer false positives or negatives. Organizations like Page AI are combining this technology with digital pathology that is then interpreted by AI to determine the most effective possible treatments. And when it comes to financial services, new financial technology firms, such as Robinhood, Acorns, Wealthfront, and many others, have created intuitive, new, and personalized user experiences with their trading platforms. While the traditional hedge fund industry has faced wave after wave of money moving to passive investment strategies, such as ETFs. Man AHL, a pioneer in the field of systematic quantitative investing, has created an entire business based on the creation and execution of analytics-driven investment models. In an effort to find a better alpha, hedge funds are adopting data analytic-based investing that analyzes fundamental economic data as well as third-party data to identify trends before they occur. For example, an investment analyst can track a major retailer's shift from in-store sales to online sales by combining credit card, geolocation, and satellite data that captures the number of cars in their parking lots. In a world where data analytics and AI are more important than ever, the organizations with the best data and the best insights will win. There are some really interesting trends in the data analytics market, from the end of the Hadoop hype cycle to the new cloud reality, and even the opportunity to leverage new types of data and technologies to move beyond analytics and into AI. While there is certainly no single secret or silver bullet to addressing these trends, one critical and easily overlooked piece of the puzzle is infrastructure. In particular, a modern storage platform is increasingly important as organizations take on the challenges and opportunities associated with modern business. Let's start by talking about the end of the Hadoop hype cycle, which has left a lot of data in HDFS data lakes, or reservoirs, or swamps, depending upon the level of data hygiene, but without the ability to get the value that was promised from Hadoop as a platform rather than a distributed file store. Meanwhile, structured data in data warehouses continue to remain in siloed data marts and are seldom used in machine learning and AI use cases. We find ourselves with a lot of data and a lot of silos, but without a way to unify that data and find the value in it. Now, when you look at the infrastructure data lakes and data warehouses were traditionally built on, it's often direct attached storage or DATs. The approach that Hadoop took when it entered the market nearly two decades ago was primarily bound by the limits of networking and storage technologies. 1 gig Ethernet and slower spinning disk. But today, those barriers do not exist. And all-flash storage has fundamentally transformed how data is accessed, managed, and leveraged. The need for local DAS storage for significant volumes of data has been largely negated by the performance increases afforded by all-flash. At the same time, organizations can achieve superior economies of scale with the disaggregation of compute and storage. Compute and storage don't always scale in lockstep. Would you want to add an engine to the train every time you add another boxcar? From a pure storage perspective, the FlashBlade unified fast file and object architecture is uniquely designed to allow customers to achieve better resource utilization for compute and storage, while at the same time reducing complexity that has arisen from the siloed nature of the original big data solutions. Eliminating these silos also provides significant investment protection to organizations midpoint on their journey from more traditional applications of analytics to the modern and innovative types of examples like those in healthcare and financial services that I mentioned a few minutes ago. A second and equally important analytics-related recent trend we've seen is something I'll call cloud reality. The public clouds made a lot of promises, and a lot of those promises were delivered. Perhaps most notably, the promise of simplicity and what is now often referred to as the cloud experience. But cloud economics, especially usage-based and elastic scaling without the control that many companies need to manage the financial impact, can cause a lot of issues. In addition, the risk of vendor lock-in from data egress charges to integrated software stacks that can't be moved or deployed on-premise is also causing a lot of organizations to back off the all-in-one cloud strategy and move toward hybrid deployments, which is kind of funny in a way because it wasn't that long ago that there was a lot of talk about no more data centers. For example, one large retailer, my favorite, I will admit, without naming their name, several years ago told us they were completely done with on-prem storage infrastructure because they were going 100% to the cloud. And today, they've just deployed FlashBlade for their data pipeline because they need predictable performance at scale and the all-cloud TCO just didn't add up. That being said, while there are challenges with the public cloud, it has certainly brought some things to the table that we see most organizations wanting. First, regardless of where the data is physically stored, organizations want the best elements of a cloud experience. Simplicity and ease of use is absolutely critical. If you need a bunch of storage experts to run the system, that should be considered a bug. Another key benefit of a cloud experience is the consumption model. The ability to pay for what you need, when you need it, and seamlessly grow your environment over time, totally non-disruptively. This is actually pretty huge, and something that a lot of vendors try to solve for with finance programs. But no finance program can address the pain of a forklift upgrade when you need to move to the next-gen hardware. To scale non-disruptively over long periods of time, 5 to 10 years plus, means that critical architectural decisions need to be made at the outset, plus you need the ability to pay as you use it. We offer something for FlashBlade called Pure as a Service, which delivers exactly that. Second, in a lot of cases, applications have been built to leverage object storage platforms like S3. So they need that object protocol, but they may also need it to be fast. Fast object was an oxymoron only a few years ago, and this is an area of the market where Pure and FlashBlade have really taken a leadership position. Let's think again to the healthcare and financial examples earlier, where image data could easily be object-based, and the benefits of faster insights are pretty obvious. The third cloud characteristic that many organizations want is the option for hybrid, even if that is just a DR site in the cloud. In our case, that means, for example, supporting replication of S3 to AWS. Which brings us back to moving beyond analytics to AI. Things get really interesting when we look at the need to help the many data science and machine learning projects move from hypothetical to tangible so that we are using AI to create the most impactful results for the most people. This means bringing all the machine learning functions and model training to the data, much of which you may have captured for the purposes of analytics, rather than moving samples or segments of data to separate forms. As we all know, machine learning needs a ton of data for accuracy. That means taking a lot of satellite images of retailers' parking lots to count the cars, or learning to discern even the tiniest anomaly in a lung CT. And there is just too much data to retrieve from the cloud for every training job. At the same time, predictive analytics without accuracy is not going to deliver the business advantage that everyone is seeking. You can kind of visualize data analytics as it is traditionally deployed as being on a continuum, with the thing that we've been doing the longest, data warehousing, on one end, and AI on the other end. But the way this manifests in most environments is a series of silos that gets built up. So data is duplicated across all kinds of bespoke analytics and AI environments. This creates an expensive and complex data center. But historically, there was really no other way to do it because some level of performance is always table stakes. And each of these parts of the data pipeline has a different workload profile. A single platform that could deliver on the multidimensional performance this diverse set of applications requires didn't exist 3 years ago. That's why the application vendors pointed you towards bespoke things like the DAS environments we talked about earlier. And the fact that better options exist today is why we're seeing them move towards supporting this disaggregation of compute and storage. Enterprises today are breaking silos and bringing all their data together on a single file and object store. Data is cleansed, enriched, combined, aggregated, labeled, and put back into the same object store as it traverses various stages on its journey to insights. This data is then used to train machine learning algorithms and serve inferences, all of which hopefully leads back to an improved user experience or a problem solved. When it comes to a platform that is a better option, one with a modern architecture that can address the diverse performance requirements of this continuum and allow organizations to bring the model to the data instead of creating separate silos, that is exactly what FlashBlade was built for. Small files, large files, high throughput, low latency, and scale to petabytes in a single namespace, and just as importantly, a single rack of space, is what we're focused on delivering for our customers. At Pure, we talk about it in the context of delivering a modern data experience. Because at the end of the day, that's what it's really all about, the experience for your teams and your organization. As enterprises embark on building the next generation of customer experience, be it in financial services, healthcare, retail, or other industries, it is essential that they're empowered with data and insights that they need. Insights from the data, whether they are from human interaction with data or AI-based insights, require a robust, centralized, and unified fast file and object foundation to support the data pipeline. Today, as we deal with the crises caused by the coronavirus, this new data-to-value dynamic is more critical than ever. I'd actually like to close with a real-world example that has the potential to impact every single one of us, and it reflects the best of the technology industry, as many of the other technology organizations participating in this conference are also contributors to their work. The example is called Folding at Home. For those of you not familiar, Folding at Home is a distributed computing project aimed at helping scientists develop new therapeutics for a variety of diseases, specifically COVID-19 at the moment, by the means of simulating protein dynamics. Folding at Home leverages the unused processing power of personal computers to create a high-speed, high-performance system on which to run its one-of-a-kind research platform. Before COVID, Folding at Home had 30,000 devices running full-time each day. That number grew to over 4 million within the first 2 months of the pandemic. The organization has 3 primary labs, each with 2 or 3 servers sending simulations to volunteers around the globe, then collecting all the data. There are teams of scientists analyzing the data and deciding what to simulate. As you can imagine, storage became an organizational priority very quickly. We were introduced to Folding at Home through one of our employees in a serendipitous Twitter interaction, and we donated a FlashBlade system to help address those profound organizational challenges. With FlashBlade installed, Folding at Home will be able to keep pace with all the simulations and data moving around right now. The work of organizations like Folding at Home that leverage the personal compute power of millions of members across a global network to tackle infectious disease depends on the ability to divide workloads into countless small compute batches that are then reunified and mined for value. We built FlashBlade with the knowledge that data profiles and performance need to vary throughout the workstream to maximize value, which is why FlashBlade Unified Fast File and Object is architected, not just for the challenges of modern data, but also for its potential. Examples like folding a home reinforce the importance of infrastructure, that not-so-secret secret to solving many modern analytics challenges.